Oh, I'm sorry. Does it offend you that I have a picture of Racing God on my computer screen? Well, too bad. One of only many topics we're going to be talking about in this, The Racers TV News. It's back. Buggity, buggity, buggity. Let's go
racing, boys! Some legends are told. Kyle Larson with a blinding restart. Kyle Larson will win his third time in a row here in Michigan.
The bumper to the back of the 24.
Drag job. Drag job.
Chase Elliott, win in the Monster Energy Cup Series.
Welcome back to the Racers TV News. I'm your host, Charles Bowen. It's been a long time, and there's been a lot of news stories that have happened since the last episode somewhere in... It was when Matt Kenseth came back, I believe. Eric Jones, Chase Elliott got their first career win. Will Power won the Indy 500. There's been a lot of big news stories. But... this, by far, rocked the motorsports world in general. This is Formula One related. I haven't talked about any Formula One on this channel at all. It's kind of a good start. This is Fernando Alonso. Two-time world champion, 17 seasons in Formula One. He races for McLaren right now. It came out earlier this week that Fernando Alonso would be moving away from Formula One at the end of the 2018 season. Now, what does this mean? Well, if you recall, back in 2017, this man, Fernando Alonso, Racing God, took on the Indy 500 and did a pretty good job at it. So, many people are saying that, along with McLaren, he will be going into the Indy full-time next year. It's gonna happen, guys. It's just gonna happen. Anyway, we got some NASCAR news to talk about. Two major NASCAR drivers in the Cup and Xfinity Series are announcing they're retiring. Those being Elliott Sadler and Casey Kane. Now, Elliott Sadler has been in the sport of NASCAR for over 20 years at this point. He's raced Cup, Trucks, Xfinity, which was his main forte, which is a long career, yet to be a champion in the Xfinity Series, but he's been very close many times, including last year when his own teammate won this championship in William Byron. Now, Elliott Sadler, this year has been kind of a low year for him. Been good, don't get me wrong, just hasn't won yet. He leads the points. Hear me when I say points. Not the championship. There's like wins and then there's the points. Elliott Sadler leads the points group of championship players, while Christopher Bell leads the winners. And there's, I think it is only Christopher Bell and Tyler Reddick, and that's it. Spencer Gallagher, his win got encumbered because he was Anyway, that's not it though. That's not all. After many rumors, Casey Kane will also be leaving after 2018. Good. If anything, he's more successful in dirt. He has a sprint car team who just won at Knoxville in the Knoxville Nationals this past weekend with Brad Sweet, I believe his name is, and a very exciting green-white checkered finish. I didn't watch it. I just read about it on Twitter, like everybody does. But yeah, this has to be the biggest news. His replacement will be Carlos Sainz, will be replacing Fernando Alonso in the McLaren car. I don't know how good he is, because I don't really watch Formula One as much as I should for a motorsports YouTuber. But then again, I reported on the Daytona 24, and I don't even watch him, so... Anyway, there's probably going to be a lot of retirement news, a lot of switches, since silly season's starting up. Also, Kurt Busch is going to go to the one, even though he wants to deny it along with Chip Ganassi and Stuart Haas, when Motorsports.com reported on it. So it's gonna happen. It's gonna happen. Jamie McMurray is probably gonna be out of a car. Who knows? Maybe Jamie McMurray will replace Fernando Alonso. Yeah, slim and none. Trevor Bayne could be out of a car. Matt Kenseth could possibly be back full time. Please let it happen. Kurt Busch, like I said, going to the one car. 41, no one knows. It could be Gregson. It could be Bell. It could be Priest. JTG Daugherty Racing could be changing up their roster. Once again, Bell, Priest, Gregson. Note how those are all Toyota drivers in the Xfinity and Truck Series. It's happened before. I mean, William Byron was a Kyle Busch Motorsports truck, but now he's the replacement of Jeff Gordon. Well, he's the replacement of the replacement of Jeff Gordon. Who knows what could happen in these next coming weeks? The playoffs are on. We're at Bristol this weekend. Truck races tonight, Thursday night. Xfinity's tomorrow. Cup Saturday. Night race is always fun. Kyle Busch can sweep the weekend. Picks or truck? I believe Jesse Little, son of Chad Little. He did pretty well at Dover, which is a similar track to Bristol. So I would look out for him. I wouldn't say he's gonna win, but my main pick is, once again, somehow, Brett Moffitt's gonna win. He's gonna go two in a row. Xfinity Series, Bell, Christopher Bell. Can't count him out. I don't know who's gonna be in the Xfinity Series or Truck Series in means of Cup guys. I know Kyle Busch isn't gonna be in the Trucks because he's worn that out. I don't know if he's gonna be in the Xfinity Series. And Cup Series. This is gonna be a big controversy, but I'm gonna pick Kyle Larson. He performed very well in the spring race, the second half. I'm gonna say look out for Ryan Blaney, Bubba Wallace, and Matt DiBenedetto, who all have performed very good here at Bristol. Matt DiBenedetto got BK Racing a top 10 here at Bristol in spring of 2016. So if that can happen, anything could happen. Chase Elliott, sadly, he's gonna be my underperforming driver of the weekend. Bristol just hasn't been a good track for him. I think he has like one or two top fives or top tens. But other than that, I don't see anything good coming from Chase Elliott this weekend. Anyway, that's it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Now get out of my room. What are you still doing here? Get out. Get out. Get out of my room.